Their claim is that if you eat too much protein, then it can increase your risk for muscle loss. What in the what? Hello, everybody. Today, we're going to talk about an article that I found pretty interesting. The headline, Can Too Much Protein Powder Cause Side Effects? Now, the short and sweet answer to that is, of course, yes, you can get side effects from eating too much protein powder, just like you can get side effects from anything you eat if you eat too much of it. But my interest in this article has nothing to do with a question in the headline, but rather the actual side effects they claim would happen. Because if what they're saying is true, then we are in deep, deep trouble, my health and fitness friends. Fortunately, this article is just another example of why you should be very careful about what you trust on the internet. Cause spoilers, I did read this article, I cross-checked their information, their evidence, the research they use, and I can tell you what I came across is what we know in the world as bullshit. Something I can't say or YouTube might get upset. Unfortunately, this is becoming all too common now. What a shocker. Things on the internet might not actually be true. We can no longer trust articles, studies, YouTube videos, and even people you come across in your video games.
Yo, what the fuck?
But let's be fair, let's check out the article so you guys can see for yourself. Now, the beginning of the article is pretty standard stuff, talking about the money the protein supplement industry is making, which is a lot, and also talking about RDAs and standard recommendations for protein intake for general populations. But immediately after that, we get to the fun stuff and talk about the side effects they claim too much protein powder will cause. For the first claim, let's just read it out. And I quote, "The biggest issue with overdosing on protein is that it can lead to amino acid imbalances and inhibit the body's ability to utilize other nutrients correctly." So right off the bat, we got some interesting choice of words. Overdosing on protein, make that of what you will. But let's talk about the actual claim of amino acid imbalances. First, they provided zero evidence, data, research for this claim. Now, I looked it up myself, and unfortunately, I could not find anything talking about protein powder and the effects it has on amino acid imbalances. The closest thing I found was on BCAAs, which are amino acids found in protein powder and protein in general, but the study itself, which were done on mice, found that you can reverse all of the issues connected to high intake of BCAAs if you consume other essential amino acids like tryptophan, and you can get these other essential amino acids from protein powder and protein. And also another point, their claim is on protein in general and not specifically protein powders, and that just means you gotta be really careful about what you say. But the biggest kicker is actually the next sentence. Their claim is that if you eat too much protein, then it can increase your risk for muscle loss. What in the what? They also said it might increase fatigue and weakness. I'm not sure where these claims came from, but for muscle loss, this is just kind of ridiculous, to be honest. It's not hard to find research showing the exact opposite of this claim, even in protein intakes way higher than any gym goer would eat. Again, they provided no evidence for this claim. That's just unfortunate, because if their claim is true, then that pretty much wipes out everything we know about protein intake. Luckily, unless I'm missing something, their claim is not true. Now, for the next one, they claim that higher protein intake increases your risk for kidney damage. This one's a pretty fair claim to make. However, there are some important contexts that we need to consider. For research that show higher protein intake being an issue for kidneys, the issue seems to only arise in people that already have chronic kidney diseases. So if you're someone that's otherwise healthy and don't have kidney issues already, then chances are higher protein intake is not going to be a big issue for you. Then they have a section claiming smaller side effects like bloating, gas, and constipation, which you know is kind of an issue. Those protein farts do not go unnoticed. But again, that's not exactly an issue for protein powder specifically. Same for the kidney issue. They keep talking about protein in general, which changes the whole point of this article. But what's even more interesting about this article is actually what they recommend as far as protein intake, while keeping in mind that they do not want you to eat a lot of protein. So my usual recommendation is 1.6 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight per day. This goes for pretty much all fitness goals, especially people that really want to squeeze out all the muscle growth they can. So you would think they would recommend something lower than this 1.6 grams per kilo. Again, I'm just going to read it out, and I quote, "If you're trying to gain muscle mass, then between 1 and 2 grams of protein per pound of body weight is recommended." For all you math magicians out there, I got you. 1 and 2 grams of protein per pound of body weight is equivalent to 2.2 and 4.4 grams of protein per kilogram of body weight. So to avoid eating too much protein, you just gotta eat way too much protein. But that is the entire article. I'm pretty sure I didn't miss anything here. But if there is something I'm missing that you see, please let me know in the comments, because I really need to understand how they came to these conclusions. Because if what they're saying is true, then I pretty much gotta delete my whole channel. But if I'm not missing anything, then... If you enjoyed this video, please give it a trusty thumbs up and share it with your protein-loving friends. Subscribe for more. As always, thank you for watching, and don't forget to get your protein. Just not too much.